So in order to understand the relation between the different concepts, like the concept of roles and objects and tasks, we need an ontology. And in this case, the ontology starts with tasks. One of the interesting things is that each task, in fact, has a goal. You could even consider the definition of the task an activity that has a goal. So this is a very important relation. Now, there could be more than one task that are related. Task could, in fact, have subtasks. The task of writing a letter could have as a subtask to consider carefully the content of the letter, and another subtask to consider the address of the person you want to send the letter to. In the same way, goals could also have sub-goals. Sub-goals meaning that in order to prepare a nice dinner, you will prepare an entree, and you will prepare a dessert, and you will prepare the possibility to have a drink, for instance. One thing that you should keep in mind is that the subtasks of a task have their own goals, and this need not be the sub-goals of the main goal. Let me give an example. If you want to get some money to do shopping, you can go to an ATM, to a money machine, insert your card and get some money. The main goal of the task of going to the ATM for money, the main goal is to get some cash. And a sub-goal of to get some cash is to get the right amount of cash and to get the cash in the type of dollar bills or coins that fit the type of expenses you are going to take. Now, the main task of getting money from the machine, from the cash machine, would include that you have to identify yourself. And in order to identify yourself, there's another subtask of that one, that's to insert your plastic pass, and another subtask that asks you to insert your private number, your PIN code. Now, in order to reach these goals, you have to put this plastic card in the machine, and later on you have to remove the plastic card. But this has not to do too much with the goal of the overall task of getting cash. So in the early cash machines, we had a problem that people would insert their card, insert their PIN code, and then they would get their money, and their final goal has been reached. And this final goal would have a sub-goal of I need $20 bills and a couple of $10 bills. And if that's the case, people would say, okay, I succeeded, and they would walk away forgetting to take their plastic card. So, subtasks are not immediately related to the sub-goals of the overall goal. Keep that in mind. Now, tasks are performed by agents. Agents are people. Or agents could be groups of people like the secretariat or the faculty or the office or my company. And agents could be systems like my answering machine or maybe the railway system, where the railway system consists of people and machines and networks. All these are agents, and agents in fact will play roles. Roles meaning that agents do certain things. You could say the role-playing means that a certain agent could take another role, could decide to take another role, or could be told to play another role by the boss or by the rules of the company. And in that respect, we could say that roles are in fact meaning that if I play a certain role, I'm responsible for that task, the task that's related to the role. And on the other hand, we could say, in fact, the tasks define what the role means. The tasks define what the person playing that role should do. Now, in relation to tasks and roles, there's the concept of objects. Objects are part of performing tasks in different ways. Sometimes a task can only be performed if the object is there. I can only get money from the cash machine if I have my plastic card with me and if I still remember my PIN code. So the object is responsible as a condition. In other cases, the object could change because of the task. The object could be the letter I'm writing, and by typing the letter, by performing the task, the content of the letter and the letter itself changes. And even the letter could be created by the task. I'm doing something wrong here. Objects can have sub-objects. Objects can contain other objects. A directory in my computer contains files, and one of these files could be a letter, and the letter as such contains other objects like the title of the story, and the words of the story, and maybe pictures, and maybe references at the end of the story. So objects could contain other objects, and in fact the environment in which I perform a task, like my office, or like the desk in my office, could be an object that's relevant for performing the task, because I perform the task inside such an object sometimes. Objects are related to roles and are related to agents, in a way that objects are used by agents, and objects are used by agents that perform a certain role. Sometimes objects are used because they belong to the role, so if somebody else takes that role, that person will use the object. And sometimes objects are more or less owed by an agent. An agent can decide, this object is mine, and even if I delegate the role to somebody else, it still is my object. I can ask somebody else to do some spell checking in my letter, but it's still my letter. So even if I ask Microsoft Office to repair my spelling errors, it's still my message. So this means used by. Now, this is a nice ontology for anything that we could expect. If we could expect that there are tasks and there are certain agents to be performing the task, taking some roles and using some objects, everything is fine and they will reach their goals. But sometimes something happens outside of the task world proper, and in that case we call it an event meaning something happening from outside the task world itself, like a power failure or like an alarm bell running or like somebody disturbing me performing my work. And this means that I have to do something that I wasn't intending to do, something that I didn't expect, but since the event happened, I now have to do it. So this is why we use events as some kind of message from outside of the world that we still have to react in our task domain. And herewith, I think the complete ontology is finished, and you will find out that anything you want to analyze in relation to people performing tasks with the help of other people and with the help of information technology can be analyzed and described and even designed by using these six concepts and their relations.